For example, Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online yoga workshop, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuck Cultural Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties in the whole Bhutan. Let's start our sun salutations. So with the mantra chanting and sloka chanting, we are starting. So according to your traditional belief system, you can follow chantings or you can follow only physical practices. So keep your position straight and come to samasthiti and pre-position. And check your breath and dress and your mat. Then after that, very slowly spread your arms with a side stretch with inhalation. Turn them out and lift your arms up. Pranamasana above to the head, Kailasha Mudra. Then very slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level called Anahata Pranamasana. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tatvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drushtaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Haim Hraum Raha मित्र रवि सूर्य भानु कगपूष्ण हिरण्य गर्भ मरीच आदित्य सवित्र अर्क भास्कराय नमः. Touch your arms forward, then lift your arms up and once completely pull yourself up and slight or medium or deep back bend Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then again keep your body straight, once completely pull yourself up. So coming to standing forward bending posture, Padahastasana. When you have any issues related to lower back or spine or neck or head or facial organ disorders or blood pressure issues or heart ailments, avoid doing or take your own pace of doing. Then remaining people can completely bend the body forward up to their convenient level or towards the floor and try to keep your head completely inside. Then here right leg is your back leg. Call Aswa Sanchalanasana. Push your body down and forward and lift your chin up throughout the practice. Press your one way of the abdomen and lift your chin up and stretch your thigh muscle. Then after that, slowly keep your back leg straight and be on the toes and lift your knee against the gravity. Then very slowly join your forward leg to back leg without lifting your hips up. And coming to Santuranasana or Dandasana, few seconds stay, but this posture also may not suitable if you had already lower back issues and spine issues. Right, remaining people completely bend the body forward towards the floor. Resting posture or Ashtanga Namaskarasana. Try to keep your forehead or chin on the floor and two palms and chest and two knees and toes are on the floor and stay for a while. Then like a sea wave, push your body, lift the body up and attach your body towards the posture called Bhujangasana. And against your shoulders and against the gravity, lift your body vertically up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, and 4, come back. Keep your head straight, back leg toes on the floor, and very slowly lift your knees up, push your body inside called Parvatasana or Mountain Triangular Posture. But please remember that Mountain Triangular or Parvatasana is semi-inverted posture and also a kind of forward bend. Take care while doing. Right leg again is your forward leg here, Aswa Sanchalanasana, and push your body down as well as forward for better pressing of the abdomen and better stretching of the legs. And back leg straight on the toes, lift your knee up against the gravity, then slowly keep your back leg forward, Padahastasana. Once completely push yourself up and lift your arms and body up called Hasta Uttanasana. And after lifting the body, once completely pull yourself up and slightly or deep or medium back bending Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakrasana. Again, keep your body straight. Pranamasana above to the head. And very slowly bring your pranamasana at your chest level. Anahata Pranamasana. Then once take a long inhalation, exhalation. Then again inhalation, lift your arms. Then very slowly exhalation, wide your hands. Then very slowly turn your palms down towards your thighs. Alright, after that, wide your legs, lock your hands back and few seconds have your rest. Take a long deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, come straight. So today's our row of exercises will start. First balancing postures called Eka Pada Padma Tadasana or half lotus palmyra tree poster pose. So this is extreme balance. You can choose support of a chair or wall when you are doing this kind of practices. So keep your position straight. And from the beginning, try to focus your mind on any particular point in front of you. Then after that, fold your right leg. So please remember, when you have knee issues or thigh issues or any other related ankle issues, try to choose proper way of doing or still avoid the practices. So here, fold your right leg on the left thigh above or at the left side lower abdominal part. Then few seconds stay now. And against your knee, try to push your body slightly forward so that this will be stable. Or when you have good comfortable dress, you can directly fold and stay now. Alright, lift your one hand up. Then very slowly, second arm up. And interlock your fingers. Then completely pull up and stay here as a pose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come back to normal. Then after that, widen your both the hands. Then slowly rest your hands. Then with support or without support, slowly relax your leg from the contraction. Then slowly expand. And few seconds rest your both the legs as in post stretches. Then soon after that, slightly widen the legs. And few seconds relax your body by keeping your hand locked back. And in between your legs, create a small space. So long, slow and a deep inhalation and exhalation. And same exercise, opposite side, keep your both the legs together. And coming to alternate side, half lotus palmyra tree posture. Fold your alternate leg, half lotus. And check your convenience before doing and during the posture also. So here, hold your body posture well. Then after that, slowly widen your both the arms and lift them further up above to the head, interlock. And match your hands properly for interlock for twisting. Then completely pull yourself up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then very slowly come straight to normal and take a long, deep and slow inhalation and exhalation. Alright, very slowly come back to normal. Then after that, very slowly keep your leg down. Take a long, slow inhalation and exhalation. And again, few seconds rest for a while. Alright, come first. Take again long, slow inhalation, exhalation. So our next posture depends on the body side bending, but in a way of Dolasana or Hasta Bandha Dolasana or Arm Locked Pendulum posture. So basically, it will give good leg stretching and also good practice for the arms and shoulders. And basically, it will improve the abdominal muscle toning, as well as it is also good for the people who have been suffering from the constipation as well as obesity issues. So take care while doing. If you have any already issues called lower back issues or neck issues or any particular related issues, avoid these practices. So keep your body straight. Then here, widen your both legs to the medium or maximum, Turn your right leg to the right side. Then towards your right side, turn the body, hold your both the arms from behind. Then interlock your fingers, keep moving your shoulders back, lift your arms up. Still turn the body towards your open leg side, right side, lift your arms. Then very slowly, carefully bend the body towards your right leg. And keep your head closer to the leg if possible. Lift your arms up and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then very slowly come back to normal. And soon after that, keep your body straight. Slowly leave your arm lock. And turn your body straight. Then after that, turn your right leg straight. Then after that, keep your both the legs together. Once relax your legs by movement. Doing any simple movement to relax your legs and long, deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. Again, lock your hands back. Just try to prepare yourself to do our other side of the same exercise. Alright, same thing here. Widen your both the legs. And in between your both the legs, create medium pace or maximum pace. Then try to turn your left leg to the left side. So please remember, we are doing Dolasana or Hasta Bandha Dolasana. Arm locked pendulum posture. So here we have In fact, movement also there, but we are doing only pose, posture only. So interlock your fingers behind the body, turn your shoulders back. Alright, turn your body towards your left side. Alright, lift your both arms up. Then according to your convenience, try to bend the body forward. And while in the posture also, don't get overstrained, but keep push your head towards your neck and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly come straight to normal. Then soon after that, first leave your arm lock. Turn your body straight, turn your left leg straight. Then after that, slowly keep your both the legs together. Reduce the space between your legs. And after that also slightly lift your knee. Just keep movement, high knee movement to give more relaxation at the hip level and at the hamstring level. So long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. And coming to one leg prayer posture or Eka Pada Pranamasana. This is also balancing, but very simple balancing. Here also instructions are, if you have knee issues or particular that joint issues, try to care about your doing or avoid the practices. Keep your body straight. Fold your right leg on the left thighs, any part, left legs, any part, or if you want, try to completely squeeze your leg towards your thigh edge, you can do that also. Alright, lift your both the arms up, then very slowly come to your prayer posture. So, like this also comes under advanced level of balancing while you are doing mantra chanting. Especially these postures also useful if you had a thought of doing mantra chanting or meditations in these postures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9, then very slowly leave your arms, then very slowly rest your legs, then come back. Then relax your body, relax your breath, then take a long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, after that same exercise opposite side, fold your alternate leg on any part of your below leg or at the thigh edge, keep your body straight. And coming to pranam at your chest level, and few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then very slowly strides and come back to normal and relaxations enough. Again, very slowly take a long, deep inhalation, exhalation. Alright, so our next exercise will be on the sitting postures called lotus posture, and further Baddha Padmasana or locked variation of the lotus posture according to your freeness, according to your convenience and according to your health conditions, you can choose this kind of exercises. But please remember, when you have severe knee issues or arthritis or gout related issues, avoid doing or take care while doing, but still please take good advice from your yoga teacher and as well as physician. So on any convenient surface, properly sit and stretch your both the legs forward. Then after that, keep your body slant on the arm support. Then fold your two legs. Once relax your both the knees and the hips and the thighs. Alright, so in our previous beats also, we did this Padmasana lotus posture practice. But here also I'm applying the same method. So first fold your right leg vertical, then slowly pull, push them inside. Then after that, try to press it down towards the floor. So here in this exercise, try to lift your that folded leg ankle with that one hand or with two hand support. Then try to put them on the thigh. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then here try to press your folded leg knee with the same side hand help or two hands help. But for a while observe the strain, how much strain you are giving on the ankle level and the at the knee level. And then very slowly come back to normal, then slowly wide your leg and stretch your leg, a few seconds rest. Just take a long inhalation, exhalation, just to prepare yourself to do opposite side and keep your body straight and samasthiti. Then here also, the other leg fold should be vertical. Then after that, towards your same side, just make it flat.
and fuse against, observe your thigh strain. Then here also once, arrange your both hands or one hand to lift your ankle to put it on the alternate leg, open leg thigh and fuse against the strain now. Then try to keep, observe your strain on the thigh and the hip level. So right now, folded leg sides, hand should come on the knee to press your knee towards the gravity, then slowly come back. So while you are pressing your knee, automatically your ankle also getting a kind of strain. Then take care while doing this kind of simple squeezes and twists. Last count, press and stay now. 1, 2, 3, then 4, come back, relaxations. Then long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Alright, this time fold your right leg and directly fold your right leg on the left thigh. Then here arrange your second leg, also fold, that should become under your above leg, right leg. And few seconds stay now. So this is what we call half lotus posture. Half lotus posture. So here in this same posture, while doing this same posture, when you have no pressure or when you have less pressure or when you are totally okay with this setup, folded leg side hand should move back behind the body to catch that same leg toes. Then few seconds stay now. Ardha Baddha Padmasana or half locked lotus posture. So here also, when you once locked your toes, automatically it will give a kind of cramping sensation. So if you have more strain on that, immediately relax and again rejoin the exercise. So few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4 and relaxation. Then very slowly turn your arm back and few seconds rest your shoulders and rest your legs. Then once relax your legs, relax your toes, relax your knees. Take a long slow inhalation exhalation. And opposite side, same practice, keep your body straight. Once come to Samasthiti, pre-position, then after that fold your left leg and that should be come up on the alternate leg thigh. Then soon after that fold your right leg also under your above leg, so that it is itself giving a good rest on the above leg. Alright, now try to keep pressing your knee. After that try to press your, especially folded leg, above folded leg, above folded leg heel must come at the lower abdominal region. Then here, same folded leg sides hand should come back to wrap the body, to lock the same leg toes and few seconds stay now. So here throughout the practice, you can turn your body slightly towards folded leg knee side or towards your concerned left side or right side, or keep your body straight. So be very convenient movement in the posture. So here, this is only half lotus or Ardha Baddha Padmasana or half locked lotus. Then very slowly release and very slowly relax your two legs. So take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. So when you have big watches or when you have any other bangles, so try to remove to do this kind of next practices. All right, now this time, like when you are totally intend to do this lotus posture, please perform, or when you have noticed any issues while doing lotus posture, just avoid this practice. Maybe some of the people can do this lotus posture. Fold your right leg on the left thigh edge, completely press it towards the abdomen. Then after that, fold your alternate leg and very slowly with the two arms support, lift your leg and put it on the other leg. So come to the completely lotus. So here, first observation, Baddha Padmasana or Sampurna Padmasana. So first observation must be like, your both the heels should come towards the lower abdominal region. Then after that, open one hand to catch your toes and check the convenience of your second leg and the squeezing sensation and the knee level compression. Then slowly come back. The other hand also just wrap and check the convenience of the two legs and two hands, and 1, 2, and 3, then come back. So once take a long inhalation, once recheck before adding two hands wrapping towards the two alternate leg toes. Alright, now first, at your convenient region, you can fold any hand first. Then try to fold your remaining arm also to catch your same leg. Again, few seconds stay now. Throughout the practice, point your toes towards your body and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly release and relaxation. So this Baddha Padmasana also good posture for the meditations as well as mantra chanting. While doing this kind of exercises, maybe at the some kind of sensation will be coming at the knee level. For that purpose, you can put one pillow or one brick under that, especially that concerned knees. So take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Then very slowly open your one leg out from the contraction. Then slowly stretch your leg. Then second leg also out. Then very slowly relax your two legs and relax your spine. Then soon after that, still you can choose good way of relaxing to the knees and the leg levels by moving your both the knees towards your right sides and left sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly strides and come back. Long and slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. And our next exercises will be Matsyasana, fish posture. The second one is Viparita Karani Mudra or Viparita Karani Asana or inverted pose. Again, we are doing fish posture and Matsyasana. Then our last posture will be queen of the all postures or Sarvang Asana or shoulder stand pose. Again, see, please remember, after doing inverted posture, it is a way of doing fish posture, but for create more easiness to the participants, I'm first doing back bending, after that inverted, again back bending. So I'm composing this way, first back bending and inverted, again back bend, again inverted, again back bend. So I'm giving more importance for the back bending exercises. So right, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. So I'm requesting my video technician to come on my right side or left side at the 45 degree angle level to cover these practices. So right, and now as anyhow we know half lotus and lotus exercise, just now we have performed that exercise also. So try to properly sleep on the back on any convenient surface. So take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. But please remember, when you had already had issues with the enlarged thyroid or any other facial or skull level issues or high blood pressure or heart issues, do not try to perform inverted postures without any guidance. So keep your positions right. Take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation, and slowly keep your both the arms and legs together, called Samasthiti or pre-position. So this is somewhat a pre-position for actually posture. So this time try to fold your right leg on the left thigh. So this will be very simple fish posture, half lotus fish posture, or you can add two legs also, lotus fish posture, Matsyasana with the Padmasana variation. So first I'm giving importance for the back bending, as I mentioned before. So after that, with the elbow support, then try to lift your head, and with the head support lift your chest up. Don't lift your waist, but lift your chest up. So with the arm support, it will be more easy to drag your head inside. This is one variation. Or if you have more confidence and if you have a previous experience, you can put your both the arms to lift your head up, to keep your head more inside. Once you will be okay with this angle, then soon after that, try to lock your both the toes with your both the arm support, and do not give any weight on the head. Sustain your body weight on the elbows. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then free your hands, then slowly put your both the hands on the floor. Then after that, with the arm support, lift your head and slowly rest your head. Then very slowly keep your arms completely down. Then soon after that, slowly release your leg lock from the lotus angle. Then very slowly relax your body in Shavasana. So take a long, deep inhalation, exhalation. So try to learn this kind of techniques also before adding that inverted postures in your practices. It is always good to do back bends first and then slowly come back. Now coming to Viparita Karani, this is a 45 degree angle posture. It's a preparation for the actually Sarvangasana or shoulder stand pose. But please remember, this is somewhat advanced level of exercises. When you have more flexibility and more curiosity, you can do, but with the guidance of your yoga teacher. So right, now this time take care while doing. So right, now lift your legs up, Uttana Padasana 2, half plow posture. Then after that, lift your body further up and don't keep your body straight. Now try to keep your legs towards your head, but keep your shape in a 45 degree angle or one way of cross V shape and stay now. So this is also good posture for the people who are looking forward for the spiritual energy awakenings.
few seconds stay in this posture, and in this posture throughout the practice concentrate at your eyebrow center or concentrate at your breath, and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and relaxation. Before relaxation, observe the arms first, then very slowly with the arm support try to push your body slightly forward towards the head, then very slowly drag your waist and trunk down towards the floor. Do not give any strain on the lower hips and the hips, then slowly come back to normal. Then with the hands all it will be possible. Then after that fold your legs and further open your legs and slowly come back to normal. Then soon after that slightly wide your legs and wide your hands in the thighs and turn your palms towards the sky, and few seconds relax in any convenient posture or shavasana. So because of this simple Viparita Karani Mudra or shoulder stand pose, first benefit is thyroid glands secretion. So thyroid and parathyroid gland will be active in these exercises, and also our metabolic activities will be more, and also our body will get more active. Especially in this Sarvangasana and Viparita Karani Asana, all the body organs, the positive influence will be spread to all the body organs. It will get health. So take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalations. As I have said before, we are doing a back bending exercise called fish posture, but without lotus. So first keep your body straight and both the arms together and both the legs together, and check your spinal cord convenience, check your neck convenience. So we are not doing lotus here. This is also kind of Matsyasana, fish posture. So right, both the arms, keep your elbows firm on the floor. Against your elbows, lift your head, lift your throat, lift your chest. Try to put your head on the floor. So in this posture also, do not give any weight on the head. Sustain your body weight on the elbows. Still, you can close your fist to tight your arms more, or you can open your hands. But please remember, your head is getting very less weight or no weight in this exercise. Few seconds, observe this kind of back bend. To make this same angle still more better, you can choose one pillow or two pillows or one brick, two bricks to keep them under your thoracic region or above back. Few seconds, stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then very slowly keep your both the hands down and with the arm support slowly drag your head back. Then rest your head, rest your body, and long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. So here, to encourage more relaxation to the head level, you can still move your head on the right side and left side while keeping your head on the floor. So it will give good support to your neck muscles. Take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalations. So in between the posture to posture, it is not good to give more time for relaxation. So again, we are immediately coming to the pre-position, Samasthiti. Now we are doing Sarvangasana or shoulder stand pose. So this is also a kind of advanced posture, but the level of the people's maturity and the flexibility also defines the activity. So keep your body straight. Then this time we have many variations of leg lifting, straight leg lift or folded and after that leg lift. So choose any convenient method. So right, first keep your both the legs straight to the 90 degree angle of plow posture or Ardha Halasana. From there, with your arm support, with your trunk support, just push your body towards the head first. Then soon after that, attach your hands at your hip level, that should become under your hips. Then soon after that, very slowly drag your elbows inside, shoulders inside. Keep your position straight to the 90 degree angle. So throughout the practice, your chest bone should come towards your chin to press your throat more. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4. For doing the same exercise, still if you have knowledge on the making of the props, you can choose towel help or pillow help to keep them under your shoulders. 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then with the arm support only, slowly push your legs towards your head while dragging your trunk down towards the floor. Then very slowly, carefully keep your trunk down towards the floor. Then soon after that, few seconds stay in this Ardha Halasana to give extra relaxation at your hip level. Then from there, very slowly fold your legs, then keep your foot on the floor, called Hasva Stambhasana. Again, few seconds stay in this posture. Then if you want more relaxation at the hip level, you can just try to keep your both the knees on the abdomen with hand lock or without hand lock. Few seconds stay. And after that, slowly open your one leg and slowly open your second leg. Then soon after that, wide your legs, spread your arms wide, and few seconds relaxations. So long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. So in between the practices, if you already felt like any inconvenience or unevenness, immediately withdraw the practice and choose some other relaxation practices. After once you will be totally free, then only you can resume the class. Alright, coming to the last exercise, let's end this session with the back bend again. So choose any convenient back bending or give first priority for the again fish posture only. So that already we have learnt lotus posture, fish posture, as well as open leg fish posture. Also choose any variation, but only thing is your neck and your chest must be involved in this kind of fish posture. So try to keep your both the arms at your ear level. Keep your both the palms firm on the floor by turning your fingers towards your shoulders. Then after that, lift your head and chest up with the help of your hands. Then after that, try to keep your head on the floor. Throughout the practice, you can put your palms like in the same posture. Or you can keep your elbows down at your chest level to firm, to keep them vertical. And here also, you can choose your elbows to act like a pillars to lift your head up to give less strain on the neck and on the head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then finally, if you are totally convenient in this posture, you can interlock your both the fingers on the abdomen. 7, 8, 9. Then very slowly open your hands. One hand should come on the head level. Second arm also should come on the head level. Keep them on the floor. Then lift your head and slowly leave your head. Then relax from the strain. Then very slowly keep your both the hands down. Then soon after that, wide your both the legs, then few seconds relaxation. So especially the people who are doing more standing jobs or like some like people doing in the hospitals, their work is related to forward bends or side bends or some uneven bends. For them, this kind of fish postures or back bending postures really helpful. Then very slow. Slowly keep your both the legs together and hands together. Then towards your right side or left side, turn your body. And your below hand should act like a pillow. The remaining arm should act like a pillar. And fold your two legs as max as possible towards the abdomen. So to give less strain or without strain on the chest muscle and then the body, with the help of your limbs, then very slowly get up. And then very slowly sit down. Alright, then soon after that, once take care of your breath, take care of your posture and take a long deep slow inhalation, exhalation. Then very slowly come back to normal. Take a long, slow and deep inhalation, exhalation. So please remember, body required more back bends rather than forward bends. So especially in the evening, physical bodies will be very flexible. So try to use that kind of flexibility to do more back bends. Okay, coming to the pranayam practices. So today also we have the same exercise, Bhramari pranayam, sound making pranayam, and Kapalabhati, Kriya Abhyas, cleaning technique. Then after that we have that Bhairava mudra, one of the important like hand gesture to keep ourselves healthy and energetic way of spiritual upliftment. So coming to the first posture, lotus or again half lotus or any other convenient posture to do pranayam. Choose any convenient surface, chair or bed or at the wall support or on the mat. Be very convenient and confident while doing the practices. Keep your position straight.
So here also we have mantra chanting and sloka chanting. According to your traditional belief, you can choose all these chantings or you can follow only physical exercises. So keep your position straight and take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. Then keep your pranamasana at your forehead level and with your all devotion. Om Kesavaya Swaha. Om Madhavaya Swaha. Om Narayanaya Swaha. Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyardham Asana Purvakan Pranayamadin Karishe. Om Sandha Sandha Sandhi. And keep your hands down. So this sloka is saying that, in other words, it is saying that practices in the yoga, advanced level in the yoga practices or all styles of the yoga practices, intention is same, called spiritual upliftment with a kind of disciplined life. So to reach this kind of two levels, yoga is a very simple and swiftest, surest and safest path to make us healthy and wealthy, like physical wise and through the mind as well as social wise also. And coming to the actually practices, coming to Kapalabhati as well as Brahmari, Kapalabhati is saying that Vastrava Loha Karasya Racha Purav Sasam Brahmau Kapalabhatir Vikyata Kapadosha Visoshini. The special way of drawing or the special way of breathe out with stroke and speed will definitely eradicate the phlegm level issues from the skull level and the head level and the facial level, throat level, also chest level. But the speed and the stroke are very important, but initially for the beginners or for the people who are having this blood pressure issues or any other complications, ear complications or facial organ complications, should not perform the actually speed and fast. They have to choose very slow pace of doing, or still if you have any health issues, avoid the practices. And coming to Brahmari Pranayam, it is also saying that Vagat Gosha Purakam Brunga Nadam Brungi Nadam Rechanam Manda Mandam Yogindra Nameva Bhyasa Yoga Chitte Jataka Chidananda Leela. So if you want to enjoy the deep spiritual fruits or deep spiritual effects through this pranayam, it is possible, but the way of doing is very important, and continuity in the practice is also important. Basically, this kind of attempting a peculiar sounds called female bee and male bee sounds, along with breath, along with breathe in and along with breathe out. So we have two different sounds here, but because of online beginners, I'm not doing that inhalation sound, I'm doing only exhalation sound only. So basically it will improve the quality of thoughts and quality of meditations and the peace and calmness. So take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalations. Alright, coming to the practices, Kapalabhati, it's a sharp exhalations and slow inhalations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One short break after 10 strokes. Again, very slowly resume the class. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, a short break. Last 10 strokes. As a third spell, Kapalabhati we are doing. Now starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. So basically Kapalabhati comes under Kriya as well as coming to Pranayam also, but we are taking this Kapalabhati as a Kriya Abhyas cleaning technique. It's a cranium cleaning technique or frontal brain cleaning technique. So basically Bhati means it's a glowing or knowledge or perception, and Kapal means it's a kind of forehead or it's a skull part. And coming to Brahmari exercise, it's a sound making practice. So inhalation, exhalation should be performed with the nose. Here, no need to open the mouth. So only thing is, when you have any severe ear issues or any mental disturbances, so don't do this kind of exercises. Keep your position straight and close your ears with the finger help or with the palm help. So completely deep inhalation. And with the breathe out, try to pronounce the sound called makar or m sound. Now inhale. While practicing this kind of exercises, observe the resonance and the quality of vibrations. Inhale again. Then slowly complete breathing. And after immediately finishing your last round, don't keep your hands out, at least for 30 seconds time. Try to listen that internal voice. Then after that, very slowly keep your hands down and take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. Soon after that, you can commence your mantra chanting or meditations or your dhyana or your way of practicing the kind of meditation. So keep your right arm above and left arm below, called Bhairava Mudra. So in this week, we are doing this same kind of mudra. Lord Shiva's in other form called Bhairava. So this mudra resembles Lord Shiva. And especially this mudra is a kind of supposed to instill a similar strength and power to the practitioner. But the way and continuity also important in these kind of simple practices. And this mudra will bring a kind of balancing and good coordination between the right and left hemispheres of the brain. And also it is a good remedy for the anxiety and stress and mood swings. And it instills the deep peace and inner silence. And please remember, our right arm and our left arm resembles, or it is somewhat, it is a kind of replications of Ida and Pingala Nadi, or female and male energies. To keep your mind peace and calm, this is very important technique. And few seconds be stable in this kind of exercise. And once you will finish your meditations in using any kind of mudra, so try to see all possibilities, how to take a power nap or how to do a yoga nidra to give more relaxation to the body and the mind. So once you will able to finish your total yoga exercise, based on the strength level and intensity level and based on the practitioner's practice schedules, it is also advised to give half an hour time, like 15 minutes time to half an hour time to take bath, and further 10 to 15 minutes time to take breakfast. And in the afternoon, before your lunch time, try to see how to do a yoga nidra or power nap to give more relaxation to the body and mind. It will definitely improve the decision making and the quality of thought, and basically it will improve the productivity from you. And in the evening, once you will be totally free from your activities and affairs, before your dinner time, again try to choose half an hour schedule to do back bendings and inversion postures, and as well as leg stretchings, including breathing exercises. And tomorrow, when we are meeting here at the same place with the same content, we will see still more good exercises in yoga. So thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity. Stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all.